published 1731 Eastern Standard Time, the 1st of March 2018, updated 332 Eastern Standard Time, the 2nd of March 2018 VAR, as it is. Being trialed in this country has to stop now. I've been immersed in football my whole life. I was a referee for 27 years, took charge of 1,554 matches, and I was a supporter of introducing technology to help officials. But the way VAR has been running over the past 2 months is ruining the flow of games and the enjoyment of all concerned. Referee Paul Tierney regularly used the VAR system in Tottenham's 6-1 win over Rochdale. Just imagine a player scoring the last-minute winner in the World Cup final this summer and having to wait for the VAR to say if the goal is valid. That would be unthinkable. All football fans recall the clear and obvious errors they want rectified, like the Diego Maradona hand of God and France's winner after Thierry Henry's handball against Ireland. Those could have been corrected in seconds. But reviewing every goal is ruining the joy of scoring, which is too high a price to pay. The headlines after the game surrounded the annoyance of the effect of the new technology. If you look at the two decisions reviewed on Wednesday, both affected Tottenham, who had a perfectly reasonable goal ruled out and a penalty awarded. If VAR had not been in operation, the first goal would have stood and the penalty would not have been awarded. Borderline decisions should not be reviewed, as football is not an exact science, and Ink Paul Tierney, an excellent referee, seemed to differ and delay routine decisions proved how unsettling it is. I would have loved the opportunity to correct some of my most glaring errors. My own World Cup dream was shattered when I took charge of the Croatia v Australia game in 2006 and infamously booked Josip Simunic 3 times. VAR could have helped and I could have refereed the World Cup final instead of coming home early. VAR could solve glaring errors quickly, but the current format is killing the joy for everyone. People often ask me why I refereed, and my reply is simple: because I love football. I'm afraid to say this rushed introduction of VAR is in danger of ruining the game one love. In its current format, we must stop VAR now. It is killing the joy for players, fans and managers. If it is massively improved, come back to us. But for now, English football does not need it. Yes, the decision to award an indirect free kick after Sun Heung-min's penalty was incorrect. Sun fainted during his run-up, as the law allows, and not at the end of it, which is banned. So with VAR in place, why didn't the video ref help Tierney to get it correct? If it's because protocol doesn't allow him to, then it's a fine.